Yeah, yeah, Fantasy and Color, we back in here. I'm Rob Ayala.
I'm Kadeem Phillip.
And as you can see, we on Zoom. We still Zooming because it's still a pandemic out here, y'all.
Yeah, we got to respect the rules. We got to respect social distancing rules.
I know some of y'all think it's over, but contrary to those beliefs, it's pretty much still.
People still getting sick. People still dying. So we ain't playing those games.
And I heard numbers going up in Brooklyn. It would be Brooklyn.
Yeah, it would be, especially the areas that it is, like Crown Heights, Williamsburg, all that type of stuff. Those are the hot spots. So,
well, they say in the Bronx too, and that's weird. Those are two different, completely places that are. It shouldn't be the same people circulating those.
It shouldn't be, but I'll be real with you. I'm not surprised because I've seen videos of people at packed parties, no mask. I'm just like.
I've been seeing some horrible stuff, and I guess I don't know. I wasn't going to touch on this so early in this art podcast, but I don't know if the strip clubs are closed, pretty much, right?
Yeah,
I've been seeing some ratchet house parties with like C-list and D-list strippers just trying to make it in quarantine.
I've seen a story where I was just like, I don't know where this is. I don't know what's going on. But there's way too much fucking shit happening. There's no mask.
I've been seeing stuff from a close personal friend. I won't blow them up, but I'm just worried about their livelihood right now.
I've definitely seen a few followers where I'm just like.
And these are like D-list, E-list strippers. These aren't top notch. These are like some species. I'm talking about girls who aren't cute enough to have an OnlyFans page.
Man,
you gotta go get out of and rent project apartments.
I don't know how people do it. And like I've been seeing people go to Atlanta, and it looked like you would swear.
You a
like
strip
Atlanta.
Club guy? You don't take me as a strip club guy.
No, I'm not. I've been, but I'm just not.
It's a tourist thing. I like going. I enjoyed it when I used to go with like my co. I like going with other girls. Like it's more fun when you go with girls. Even the strippers are more friendly. I'm not going to a strip club with me and four dudes looking like a wild pack of animals in the prowl.
With dudes in a strip club is mad fucking weird to me. It's suspect. It feel like wolf pack mentality, like when it's mad dudes. I've been with my old roommate. She used to love fucking strip clubs. I would come, but I don't know. It's just
you know what my thing is. This I know you don't really like me. I need you to like really like me for real. Like don't. Just... I'm not gonna just give you all this money.
It feels so business.
Business as usual. They there for, and that's about like a lab dance. I feel like that's just too much. It's like this is officially a transaction now.
Yeah, it's like.
Where'd you go? Sin City.
I've been to Sin City. I've been to Lust. I've been to Sue's.
Okay, yeah, but Sin City was nice because you know they would be like on their like. Little area and you kind of like look up to them. I like that. Like that's cool. I put my old dollar. I walk away. With the lap dance, I feel like I'm like it's a commitment now.
You can't go no.
Yeah.
You're locked in. Like hand, give me the money. And it's like, I don't knock it. Get the money.
I know you have creeps that go to the strip club to be aroused. I can't be aroused in a room full of 200 people. Like
I think I went to Club Lust, and I remember just this dude. He was just in the corner with like his drink at his table, and like this girl's walking around giving dances, and like he just pulled out this money, and just like while they're dancing, he looks so like you ever seen someone just look so joyful but look creepy at the same time, and I was just like.
There's nothing worse than being that old nigga at the strip club too. Like my uncles and them niggas don't wear underwears when they go to the strip club. Creeps.
That's nasty.
It's creeps. Nasty. No,
that's horrible. That's trash. That's nasty.
When do you become that old nigga? So think about it. If a stripper is, I'm still good though, right? Like if a stripper is 20, I'm 39. Am I borderline? Nah, I'm still good. I'm still good in the strip club, right?
I'm not real with you. I don't even know strip club etiquette. So
no, but I just meant when are you that? You know, like when you like everybody, you could be every stripper's dad. That's when that's when it's awkward.
You peeking like you're peeking. Like you're
but I play younger on TV. I'm like an actor, so I might be able to rock out. But that's awkward. You don't want to go to the strip club and just be everybody's dad's age.
No,
I mean like the strippers.
I think that's when you have to retire to strip club.
Unless you're just a creep, because you got certified creeps out here that that are always gonna love an 18-year-old.
Yeah, see, those guys, they just gotta stay somewhere in their dungeon. Like, keep them in their dungeon, their little creep fest.
Did you watch P-Valley? Probably not. I know you didn't watch that.
I've heard, you know me.
I know, you're not the biggest, yeah. You watch things months later, right?
Like, I'm just around getting around to, what is it, Lovecraft Country?
You know what's so crazy? On HBO, right?
Yeah, I'm just about to start.
Yeah, that. And you know what's so crazy? Christy just started watching it without me, so now I gotta watch it. She has horrible, like, show etiquette. You know, couples watch shows together? She's the worst. She just starts shows, and we'll start it together. She'll just finish it without... Horrible. Horrible show etiquette.
Me and Tasha, like, if we got a show, we'll try and binge it. Like, in the weekend that we'll be, like, together, we'll try and binge it within Saturday, Sunday.
And the way your time is set up is almost like that's... It's, like, time for that, too.
Yeah.
Y'all see each other when y'all see each other, and y'all catch up. But mm-hmm. We all over the place anyway. We just have to... We just talking nonsense. We're supposed to talk about strippers, I promise. I don't even know how we got there. Fantasy and Color Podcast, we back. Rob Ayala.
Dean Phillip.
Yo, I got a little impromptu question for you. You know, we talk a lot of music, but I don't think I've ever asked you this question. Who's your top five females of all time? You chauvinist, you never even mentioned it.
First of all, don't put me like that. Don't do me like that.
What female rappers do you like all time?
All time, okay. Without really particularly, do I have to put it in order? No, not really. Missy's like, even if I did have to order, Missy probably be one. Yeah. Missy's like one of my favorite artists. I'm a big Queen Latifah fan. Like a lot of her stuff, like, should. Was like one of my favorite things. Queen La, Missy. Okay, here's why I battle. I have a kind of like a biased like Lil' Kim. Just
what do you mean?
Being from
Brooklyn, yeah.
I think
Brooklyn and just being from a certain era, Lil' Kim will always be on people's lists.
But also she was like around my area a lot growing up. Cause I grew up in the area where like, you know, fucking
I remember you told me that. Biggie too, right?
Yeah. Like he grew like St. James Place. I used to live on there where they would all hang out. So I kind of have a bias to Lil' Kim. I've always loved her music. There's certain stuff, like, when she do new music, I'm just like,
but, I know. And it's not even that it's bad. It's just...
It's kind of like I already got Lil' Kim kind of set in stone. This is where it kind of gets a little tricky.
We only got two spots left.
I would put Rhapsody up there.
Okay.
Rhapsody would be up there. And...
I just want to see it, Jay.
Me and her come and go. My fandom for her come and go, but I can't take away Nicki Minaj from this place.
So you're not putting Cardi B on your list?
Hell no.
Damn, just that's it?
It's like...
You say she didn't accomplish anything? You don't feel like she...
Not that she didn't accomplish anything, but when you look at the resumes of the people I said before, it's like one project, and even though she has some mixtapes, it's like one project to like years of... projects, you know what I'm saying?
Also, like, I also said your favorite, because I feel like you can say your mm-hmm. top five favorites, then you can say your top five of all time as far as like what they've done. Then you have to kind of put certain people, because I don't know, you could kind of argue Cardi on the list for certain things. Like she's
for certain things, maybe, but even for like, well,
she's
look
on
at
path to do everything Nicki Minaj has done. She's even done some things she hasn't.
But even for me, I'm not always crazy for Nicki. There's certain Nicki's certain moments of Nicki I'm not a fan of. It's like, I'm just like,
first album? Tell you.
Which one? Cardi B?
Yeah, the only album she had, the first album.
I like it, but I also was just like, I knew instantly when I heard it, I was like, it's a hit. Like, it's a hit. Don't matter what, there's too many hits just on album. That. There was like, if I'm not mistaken, she had like 6-7 hits off of it.
Is that a bad thing, though? That's not a bad thing.
No, it's not a bad thing, but it wasn't like, all right, in an art world, right? It's like pop art. You know what's gonna work in the pop art field. Like, you see it, you're like, that's a hit. People gonna go crazy for it. But does it show off all the skill? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Cardi B has her set tone. Like, you know what Cardi B can do?
I see what you're saying.
And to me, it's like, it's a pop, but I'm like, it's not a bad thing. I think for your first album, that's actually a
I feel like numbers talk. She's noteworthy to be on the list. So she's not worthy to be on list. If you're not just artistically.
Yeah, if you're talking numbers, she's on the list with no question. I think.
So we just said favorite, to be fair. So it's not even about if they even sold the best.
No.
I don't even know Queen Latifah sold, to be honest with you. I mean, I don't,
but I just know I loved him. I loved her energy.
Like she was big enough of an artist at the time. Like,
I don't think she. And also, Queen La was like one of the first people to cross over into like TV and film. Like, she was the first. So she made headway.
Living single early.
Yeah, yeah. Movies, all that shit.
So I think that was five, right?
Yeah, that was five.
Okay. You left a lot of people off your list. Just to take your Brooklyn card might be in jeopardy because you left Foxy off that list. Didn't even think about Foxy, right?
No. I've never been crazy about Foxy. There's just been something that never drew me.
Okay. I don't want to get you in trouble, so I'll leave it at that. Nah, but listen, let me see my top five. I no order, right? Like you said.
Yeah.
Of course, Missy has to be on it. It's just hands down. That's cliche, but she has to be on it. Little Kim is gonna be on it for me, just as far as like an all-time favorite thing.
Right.
There'll be people that are better than her, but she's gonna be on there. Like that first album is like a Biggie album. Let's be real, that first Little Kim album,
it is hardcore, pretty much
a Biggie album.
It is pretty much,
because it's no secret he wrote it. I mean, she was a performer on that. But he penned most of that record, if not all of it. Mm-hmm. That's a Biggie album. That's a female Biggie album.
I think that's why it's a classic, because it's the perfect representation. Like Biggie and a woman's like
that album is hard. If Peter Piper pecked that beat right there, I'm gonna say that.
That's one of
that joint is hard.
I love that album.
What was the other joint though?
She had a couple of them. There was a on the album.
Yeah, what was one of like the bangers like in that album? That you could tell was such a Biggie joint. I think there's a Did you see the reference track? There's a reference track of Biggie doing one of those songs on YouTube.
I think
it might be the song I was just singing too.
I have to see that. I've never seen that.
There is. It's on YouTube. So yo, I'm telling you, I'm gonna see if I can find it.
But Missy Kim.
Missy Kim, you're just disrespectful. You didn't even give Eve an honorable mention.
All right, here's my thing with Eve. I do love Eve.
And you were probably like a young kid when Eve was killing, like enough to remember it.
That was when I was getting into hip hop. Was like, Love Is Blind and all that.
Yeah,
shit.
That's what I'm saying. You was at an impressionable age. Is what I'm saying.
What happened with me with Eve is I don't know why, but.
And she's with the Rough Riders.
I feel like after the second album, I don't really remember Eve's music. After the album where she did like "Let Me Blow Your Mind" and stuff
that was the second album.
That was the second album, like "Let Me Blow Your Mind." After that, I don't remember any of her music like that.
You don't remember "Shake It Tambourine"?
I do, but I remember hating Swiss Beats. I remember hating Swiss Beats for that goddamn song.
Swiss Beats. Is the Reach guy with certain hits like because there's a few that are questionable. You know what song is a little bit annoying? You probably gonna like it though, but it's like low key cringy to me. On to the next, on to the next.
No, I swear to.
After a while, the beat gets annoying.
I kid you not. I don't want the chorus. Like if you just gave me the verses, I'm cool with that. But then it's just on to the. And it's just like, come on, fam.
I'll probably gonna name like two more from Swiss. What else?
Oh yeah,
good enough topic, but
I can't think of it now.
No, it was too much pressure.
Give me a second, and it'll come back to me.
Let me get finished my girl list.
So I'm gonna say Eve.
Mm-hmm. Let me really think hard. All right, let me not just throw Eve on there. Let me say who I really fuck with. Who I can say I really listen to. I was like, they nice. I liked Little Kim a lot. She's definitely on that list. I love Missy to this day. I'm going to have to say, damn, I really got to think. You know why? Because, let me see. So I don't want to just say somebody's name just to say it if I didn't really listen to him. I did like Eve, but it's like, did I love her albums? Who else is out there? Like, let's throw some names too. Oh, wait.
Do you have a light fan?
Oh, wait.
Like,
you know what? I like, damn, I like MC Light. I used to really like MC Light when I was young. That's an old school name, so I'm dating myself. But MC Light was fire.
That's what I was just about to say. Were you a Light fan? Like, were you like a fan of her?
Yes, MC Light.
What about Foxy? You killed me for Foxy. What about
you?
You
know
what?
Yeah, I probably would throw Foxy on my list. For my era, that 90s era, when I was like a teenager, I did listen to Foxy.
What about like Rod Digger? What about...
Wait a minute. We wildin'!
I'm not going to...
Lauryn Hill! Lauryn Hill!
All right.
No, I got to do my list over. My bad. Lauryn Hill. Lauryn Hill. Nah, but Lauryn Hill's on there. You know Lauryn Hill's on there.
Yeah.
Just for the score and her album alone, gets her on there.
Then I would probably... What would I take off? I'd take off Nicki.
Oh, I didn't even mention Nicki. All right, no, I can't front. I do like Nicki. So here's my list real quick. Here's my list. Lauren, Missy. Right. Let me keep it real. Fuck all the nostalgia. Lauren.
Missy.
Nicki. Nicki has to be on there. Ah, oh, man. Little Kim. And my number five.
Do you have Light? I mean, for you, Light.
And MC Light. MC Light, yeah. My number five. Yeah. I'll put Light over the Queen. But damn, that's only top five. Because if I had to do my 10, Queen Latifah would be on there.
If I had to do 10, I have no problem putting like Foxy and all that other shit on there.
And I'm sorry to say, Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion creeps on my list. Like, Megan Thee Stallion is actually nice.
They're creeping up there for me. Like, I enjoy Megan's music. Like, her music's fire.
But she's actually nice.
Yeah, she can rap her ass off.
She got that 90s Southern flow.
There's like, another chick who I've... She's another Southern female artist who lately she's caught my ear. And I'm like, she could rap her ass off too.
What's her name?
Mulatto.
Oh, Miss Mulatto. Miss Mulatto, I'm gonna fuck your head up. Because, you know, Miss Mulatto was a kid on Jermaine Dupri's show.
I heard that.
Remember that show with the kids? Yeah. I used to watch that with my daughter.
But she could rap her ass off.
Yeah, but only thing with her, like, now I heard her thing is, like, she talks, like, a lot of freak stuff. It's weird because those of us that know her from...
I didn't know her from that show, so it's going to be weird.
You don't know her from that, so you just with the shits.
Yeah, I'm just like, oh, I fucked with this.
Yeah, she is nice, though.
Yeah. But, if we did 10, it'd be different, but... Damn, if I gotta put Lauren.
Maybe we could just throw some. You said it right. You threw somebody off.
Yeah.
Right.
I'd probably be Nicki. It'd probably be Nicki.
Yeah.
It'd probably be Nicki because I don't like. I can say I still touch with all those people like I said.
Because like, I'm gonna be real with Lauren. This is what I'm counting. And he did have a first album, but I'm not counting that. But I'm counting the score. Just her work on the score, the Fuji album. You know the Fuji album, the score.
Yeah.
Just her on that album, period. Her solo album, right?
Right.
And then also her Unplugged album. That you have to mention that.
The MTV album
has bangers on it.
Yeah.
So to me, that gets her on the list. Even though I know, like, you could say, like, she has a shorter career, but we just like we said, Lil Kim's career that we like from when we liked her has been over a long time ago.
That's true.
So it doesn't matter how long they rocked. Just less, some other honorable mentions. I did like Lady of Rage a lot when I was into my Death Row phase.
Funny enough, I didn't even know who Lady of Rage was. I just knew her.
You didn't realize she was the chick on the Steve Harvey show?
I just knew her from Steve Harvey show. I didn't even know she was a rapper.
You don't remember her from? Oh, nah, because you
when haven't. I got older. No, then when I got older, I was like, oh shit, she's a rapper. I was like, but then it made sense.
She was on the early Death Row stuff. So she's been around for a minute.
Rod Digger, definitely.
I like Rod Digger.
Rod Digger. Who am I forgetting? I feel like I'm forgetting somebody.
Like we said, Eve. Eve deserves to be on there.
What was her name? She was on, she was like the first lady of Rockefeller. I mean, she wasn't great.
Oh, Emil?
I loved Emil at one point. Like I never did,
but we could mention her just for...
I liked her. Not even she really needs to be in this list, but just when we talk
about... How about Charlie Baltimore? But I like... She was Biggie's girl. That was intriguing to me.
Yeah.
But nah, right?
Not really crazy about it.
How about let's get some love? I don't know if you probably wasn't up on this, but like No Limit, Mia X.
Oh, I knew everybody from No Limit. Mia X, I knew of Mia X. Like No Limit was actually how it I got. How,
oh wait, Gangsta Boo. You know about Gangsta Boo?
Ooh.
From 3-6.
Of course, because she still be on Run the Jewels project. Yeah. Like she'll still be on that with Killer Mike.
She's fire.
Ooh, Trina also gotta be up there.
Oh, Trina. I love Trina when she especially when she first dropped with mm-hmm. Trick. That first You Don't Know Man, that was so fire.
There's a lot. Shit, there's a lot of people you say I pick.
These are just honorable mentions at this point.
Yeah. I think that's all I could think of at that point though. Of like, I know there's more and I'm probably gonna get murdered for it, but I can't really remember fully.
Well, let's get back mm-hmm. to those Swiss reaches. Like let's name two more beats. Let's think about it. There gotta be a few out there.
Him with Jada Kiss and OJ the Juice Man. They had a song and Swiss was all over the goddamn chorus. I forgot the song.
Not She's Phony. She's fake. I kind of like that one though.
I liked it, but it's just anytime Swiss is just like he just always comes off as extra. Like there's an extra energy about Swiss. I appreciate it, but sometimes it's like, come on, fam.
No, but that beat was kind of hot.
The beat was hot, but just Swiss is just.
Let me see what else. You know what else wasn't all that? What was the joint he did for Swiss? I mean, for T.I. back in the day.
Bring Him Out.
Yeah, that was alright. I know you probably like that one, right?
I like that for T.I. I didn't really care. Like now that you talk to me about Swiss, yeah, Swiss was kind of annoying. When
bah, 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 bah. It's like.
Yeah, now that I think about it, that beat was kind of annoying. There's a few of them, like Swiss is an interesting producer. Maybe you can tell me from a producer sense how you feel about it. Because my thing with Swiss is, I don't put him in the realms of like a Timbaland.
You don't?
But I don't. Like, I think he would be the tier under like a Timbaland. Like, I feel like if we put in like tiers of producers, I feel like Swiss is a legend. But I don't think he's like one of those like golden like when I think of Timbaland and like Pharrell.
Hold on,
like,
hold on. I'm about to share my screen. Hold on.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you found it?
Yeah, it's on YouTube. It was never lost.
Oh, shit. Let
me see. Hold on, I gotta share my sound.
Oh, I hear it.
Can you maintain you here now?
That's yes.
He was hearing it through the mic.
If Peter Piper pecked him, I bet you Biggie bust him. He probably tried to fuck him. I told him not to trust him. Lyrically, I dust him. Off like lead, hit hard like sledgehammers. Bitch with that platinum grammar. I am a diamond cluster hustler. Queen bitch, supreme bitch. Kill a nigga for my nigga by any means, bitch. Murder scene, bitch. Clean bitch. Disease free, bitch. Check it. I ride around, melting your mouth like M&M's. Roll with the mafia. Remember them?
I
remember
when I used to mess with
them.
Hell yeah.
Straight up for posse. Now strictly niggas that jostle. Kill a nigga for the figure. How you figure? Your cheddar would be better. Beretta inside the Beretta. Nobody do it better. Bet I wet you like hurricanes and typhoons. Got buffoons eating my pussy while I watch cartoons. Sleep till noon. Rap pan bridge here. Baby drinkers beware. Mostly don't see where. Frank kill niggas wise for 1.5. While you struggle and strive, we pick which pens to drive. The mafia, you wanna be them. Most of y'all niggas can't eat without per diem. I'm rich, I'm a stay that bitch.
Look, even that part that they added, he did that with his mouth.
I'm a stay that bitch.
He did that in the horn, but the horn.
Yeah. That's what you just artist.
That's like some Miles Davis shit. He hummed the horn piece that they ended up putting on.
See, that's when crazy. That's artistry. That's complete artistry right there.
Oh, man.
Man. I didn't even know that clip. I didn't even know there was a clip of this.
That's what I love about the modern world of internet. Nothing's a secret anymore.
Hell no.
Everything is right in the grips of your hands.
But you know what? That's also a downfall. Because some things are better off being like still secretive.
I know, but I'm glad that I could just find that every time I want.
Oh, of course.
It's the gift. You know what I mean? It's the gift of the curse.
Yeah. Oh, man.
That was effortless too, right?
Hell yeah.
He just went in there and just said, All right, this is what a girl should say.
Like, I'm not surprised how effortless it was, because Big seemed like someone where it just comes to him easy.
Yeah.
Like, he, it looks like it's just like, it's like drinking water.
Yeah.
Like, this shit don't even, it's nothing. Even for him to still come up with the melody in between of it, that says a lot about him just artistically.
Yeah. So let's switch gears a little bit. Let's talk about this, the state of the world right now. I don't know, nothing definite, but it seems like it could be possible. Hopefully not, but lockdown again. you think that's definitely happening?
Oh yeah, I've started to see in like what is it, Pennsylvania? Pretty much, they look like they're pretty much going on closing, like no gatherings. Like, gyms and stuff are going to start being closed probably by the end of this week. I think, I'll be honest, I don't think it's a bad thing to go on a shutdown right now. I think it's wintertime. I think it's getting cold out. It is flu and sick and cold and flu and sickness season.
Yeah.
And I think at this point, it will help in the long term more than anything. I think, like, it's cold. No one really wants to be outside anyway. It's different when we was on lockdown and it was like 50, 60 degrees outside and 70 degrees outside and everybody wanna be outside. When it's like 30, it's windy, it's snowing, no one wants to really be outside
anymore. I feel like for all that, if it's gonna do it, it should be scheduled. I feel like we should be on the same months we was locked down before, we should just lock down again. From March to, when was it?
It was March to basically like May, early May, like May, mid-May. But when was that, like 2.5 months?
And the holidays are coming. I feel like, give people the little last bit of holidays and then
lock it down. Well, I think
for the new year or whatever.
Yeah, lock it down to like, because let's be real, no one's going to be outside for New Year's this year.
I mean, there's always people who are going to want to do it.
I mean, they
you think, they are going to let? Are they going to let people even do the ball drop? Are they going to do that?
That's what I'm saying. I don't think they will.
You think not?
No, I think it's too much of a hazard.
You don't think they'll try to do a version of it?
No. I think...
They're going to do it virtually.
I think it'll be a virtual.
It'll be on TV, but not downtown?
Yeah. I don't see it being downtown. Because I just don't see... I can't see them telling people no gatherings, and then you have the streets of New York full with thousands of people to watch a ball drop.
Yeah.
And then it's just like...
But people don't listen in New York.
They don't, but a lot of those people who come for that are out of town.
Is that true? Is that a fact? Is that a Snapple fact?
I'll be honest with you. I don't know a lot of people that actually... I know in my life that actually...
When I was a kid, I went. Like, I think my family made it a thing, though. So it wasn't like we just randomly went. I think we got a hotel. I have, but you know what? Now that I say it, it was family that was out of town. That's why we were doing it with them.
Right.
We weren't doing it on our own, but to them it was a big thing. You probably wouldn't have did it if it was us. Just us.
Right. New Yorkers don't think of shit in New York as big.
Name something in New York that is a damn shame that you haven't done or saw. Mine's is, I never went to the Statue of Liberty.
Me neither. I've never been to the Statue of Liberty. Okay. I ain't never even really think about the Empire State Building. Like, I used to work by it. I used to walk past it.
I've been in the Empire State Building. Okay, so you got two on your list. You've been in the World Trade Center before it fell?
No. I was 11 when it fell.
I've been there.
Yeah.
But they used to have trips, you know. My school never went on a trip to the Statue of Liberty, or at least I didn't go.
Did we have one to Randall Island? Is it Randall Island? Well, no, it's not Randall Island.
No, it's not Randall Island.
What is it? I don't even know.
It's just his own
but,
thing.
I've never been. I don't even remember if my school ever did a trip there. But no, like those things are just. I think in New York. Is
you
just
go. You should go to the Empire State Building. That should be on your little bucket list. That's light. That's something you could just go do one day. That's a nice. That could be a date.
Legit.
That off your list quick.
I used to work on 33rd and Park. Like I was right there. I used to just walk right past it every day, just like it was nothing.
Okay.
But
that's something you could definitely knock off your list.
Now that I've been inside all this time and I'm thinking of all this stuff, I'm like, well, you know what? Why not just go up on the Empire State Building?
What else? What else something you feel like that's kind of crazy that you never done or saw in New York? You've been to all the boroughs, right?
I mean, I go to all, I've been to all four boroughs. I don't really have no reason to go to Staten Island. I don't really count that.
So you've borough. Never been to Staten Island in your life?
I've been there.
Oh, you've been there, but
so,
no, I'm just saying, have you been to all the boroughs?
Yeah, I've been to all the boroughs. Okay. Ain't nothing really.
Because that'd be weird. I mean, you know, that'd be weird. You know, if you're 30 years old, you've never been into all the boroughs. That means you need to kind of get out a little bit. Now, don't get it twisted. Nobody said you got to go back twice.
Oh, I've never.
You should have been in the boroughs at least once.
Oh, trust me, I won't be going back twice this summer.
What else? What else is a New York thing that you've never done? That you feel
like I've
you
never seen the. I've like
your New York card.
People go to see the tree.
Never seen the tree. I have. Me and Christy went maybe the year before last or so.
Tasha wants to go. I'm just like.
I was just talking about that today. She was like, "Are anybody trying to go down there now?" Like that was like.
Oh no, Natasha wants to. She wants to. Like she saw the tree.
That's something you should go do. You should see that. But that's something I did a lot when I was young too.
These are just things where I'm just like.
Growing up in that Rastafarian home. And like I said, fuck traditions. Yeah.
But you think we're going? I think we're going on a second lockdown. What you think?
I mean, yeah, at some point. At some point. I don't feel like it's now, but it's probably definitely sometime, you know, in the early year, the early new year.
I'll tell you when I think it's going to happen. I think it's going to happen the first week of December. Because Black Friday. And I feel a whole bunch of people are going to go stupid and going to go try to get all these sales. Because, you know, as much as we, you know, when you look at how this year has been, a lot of businesses took a lot of hits. So to get your money back for Black Friday, they're probably going to come up with a bunch of different sales to get their money back. Whatever type of blowout Black Friday sale, that's the big, you know, thing. And I see people just being stupid.
Well, you know what another lockdown means, right? More unemployment for people.
Like
maybe a couple of more stimulus checks. Who knows? Probably not. That's over now, right?
We haven't even. We got one stimulus check.
Don't put me in your business on camera.
Oh, excuse me. But if you really look, they gave one stimulus check out in April. Fam, that is one check in about almost 8 months. That's like less than $200 a month. Like, they don't give a fuck.
But if we get back on the lockdown, it's going to force a lot of people might not recover, like a lot of businesses.
Oh, no. I think...
A lot didn't recover from the first one.
Yeah, we're going on the second lockdown. A lot of shit is fucked up.
I don't think this is not the era to have. It's sad to say, but this is not the era to have a business, a physical business that you have to pay the rent at. Especially right now when you can't, one, have the capacity of people to make the money, and then you could just get shut down every few months, and you know.
It's not the place. Not the ideal time to have like a brick and mortar type of situation going on.
A lot of barbershops didn't make a lot of businesses didn't make it back from the first go round. You could even see it from like places that you know. You walk around now, you're like, oh damn, they not open anymore.
You walk around a lot of places in Brooklyn, it's just like the shit's just closed, and it's just like, damn, I didn't think it'd be this fucked up.
Even I actually had a barbershop right across the street. It was like the most convenient thing, right across the street for me, and they didn't make it through.
That's hard, man. It's fucking rough. I just wish.
It was a selfish moment when you worried about your haircut and somebody lost their business.
I mean, hey, man, listen. If we go on the second, I'm hoping we don't go on it immediately for selfish reasons because I need to get my hair done. My hair.
You're gonna have one big dread if we go on another lockdown.
At that point, I'm just cutting it off. At that point, I'm coming out of here with like a season.
I'm actually growing my hair because I realize I don't want to be reliant on the barber so much. So my hair is even right now. It's just growing. Mm. I'm gonna just let it do what it do for a while.
You gonna afro it out?
I mean, for now, I don't. You know, I'm not just walking outside picking it out. But I'll deal with it as it grows. But for right now, look, we got a lockdown. We got a lockdown. Ain't no barbershops. So all I have are fades. Then your hair's all uneven.
It's a wrap. That's why I'm just like,
your hair's uneven. You look dusty.
Dusty.
You ever said
you ain't
that?
Cute. You ain't cute. Your hair uneven. You look dusty.
Who points out your hair's uneven? All right? That's such a detail you ain't even think about. Like, damn, my hair's uneven?
That shit hurts you. Like, that's that type of joke where you think about it later. Like, you be in the mirror like,
yeah, I gotta go get a haircut. Yo, even me out.
You be like, yo, it's a little, you know, just even it out. But I think
what you been listening to these days, music wise?
More R&B. I've been. I don't want to say I'm burnt out on rap, but I'm like I've been listening
rap
to
is burnt
like,
out on rap.
Yeah, some of the stuff I'm just a little over, but more R&B, like some R&B albums I just didn't touch on for the last few years or last few months.
Okay.
Like, heavy in my rotation has been the Sir Chasing Summer album. I really love that album. I've been listening to this artist, Shmino. I found out about Shmino like last year, but he's like a rapper, singer, whatever the hell he is. But he's like somewhere in the middle. I do a lot of instrumentals. I like to listen to a lot of instrumental stuff when I'm just painting.
Me too. There's a lot of instrumental music out there too. A lot of people don't know about. It's just like a whole different. Especially when you, like you said, when you're creating, you're just better than just the beats playing sometimes instead of like certain songs.
Yeah, and you don't have to hear a whole bunch of bullshit that you don't really care about.
Exactly.
Where it's just like there's like I haven't really been looking forward to any projects. I know like the last project I heard was like I know Drake had announced he's dropping in January, but I'm just like meh.
There's a few albums I gotta recommend to you. I don't know off the top of my head, like, mm-hmm. but stuff that I came across that you might like, I'll send it to you.
Definitely.
But also, like, I've been like, let me see. I could tell you right now. Let me go to my.
Ooh, article. Kumasi Washington, you put me on to him.
Oh yeah,
and
yeah,
I've
yeah,
been playing
yeah.
a lot of. I played his project. First of all, I didn't realize for a short project that shit longer than a motherfucker.
Oh yeah,
that
yeah,
shit
yeah.
sound great.
But did you get into Thundercat's more recent album?
Oh yeah, I love it.
That album's dope.
Like the first time I listened to it was like early lockdown, and then it was just like, oh yeah, it's good. And then the more that I've been listening to it, I'm like, holy shit, this.
Did I ever put you on? I don't know if you ever spoke about it, or maybe you know about them. You know about that group, Bad Bad Not Good?
Yes, you talked to me about them. Okay. You're the reason why I got into them.
Cause they have good music to like mm-hmm. paint and zone to.
I've been listening to them a lot too.
And of course, you know Alchemist. I'm always anything.
Of course,
he released a good.
You listen to the new album?
Yeah, The Food Villain?
Yeah.
Of course.
I'm not surprised.
I love it.
I'm not surprised.
If you watch, those are all clips from the show. From Fuck That's Delicious.
Hold on.
All the little vocal clips?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's from the show. But I could imagine it's hard. It's hard for... you know, for Pete rappers in the industry right now, entertainers, because they can't do the shows like the way they used to. I'm sure there's some type of shows.
And if you live in Atlanta.
Atlanta. I'll just like out like places where the weather's nice. I would assume maybe Cali, you could do more outside stuff than you could do here.
I think it's more, I know out the country it's not that bad. Out the country, because they're under control, there's the ways that they're doing it different. I know in places like Atlanta and stuff, they're still doing like parties and hostings and stuff, but it's not like they really got the COVID shit under control. So it's kind of like you rolling the dice. But yeah, I think that's why you haven't seen a lot of artists drop.
Yeah. I mean, because, but you might as well at least drop music and stream. I know it's not, you know, it's not where you get the most.
I mean,
but at least you're staying relevant.
I think, yeah, it's that, but also for, you know, it's still art. So, you know, for art people, they want their art to be full, their vision to be fully like, I can do this with my vision. And I think that, like, that's the main reason why I don't think we've, that's why I'm surprised even Drake pushed it back to next year. But I'm like, he probably did that so that I hope that it'd be better.
Yeah, when is it coming out?
Because Drake was January.
Oh, okay. I doubt it's going to be that different by January.
No, but by the time, usually artists like him, he goes touring by like, what, the springtime? Like, yeah, January, by March, he's probably on spring, he's on tour. So he would be hoping by March of 2021, you know, a full year shutdown, he could probably do touring. But I don't know.
Yeah, they might have to figure out a whole new thing to, just to get money. That's, people have to get creative now. They might have to create some virtual thing where maybe it's less. You probably can't charge as much as you would for a real ticket, but they might have to do some virtual thing where you, once you buy a ticket, you have access and you might have to experience it. But it's still exclusive. You get what I'm saying? It's not like everybody gets something that's live that you only have access to, but from home.
That's a, that's the next thing, right? But then that's weird because then sooner or later, that just take over concerts, period.
Well, only if we can't physically do it.
Yeah. And the way, let's be real, the way America goes.
Because you're still going to want to physically go. That's always going to be the best thing to do.
Yeah.
It's not like if the world went back, we're going to go, nah, let's not even go. I'd rather just watch it from home. Yeah. People still going to want to watch these people live. Don't you think?
That's true. Yeah, the experience of a live.
Forget about our lazy asses. You heard? We're going to watch it from the crib.
I ain't going to front. I think about that with movies, and they'd be like, movies are about to be streaming a lot. I'm about to be like, I don't see me paying a lot for no tickets. I don't know.
I know. But sometimes I like the movie experience. I mean, I'm old enough to still experience, like to want that.
I miss that.
Movie experience, you know?
Yeah. I miss sneaking candy into my fucking jacket. That's my business.
Oh, from other stores? From local bodegas?
Yeah. Go to like the bodega if there was like a fucking like a Dwayne Reed down the block or some shit.
Oh, yeah. Well, I've done every element in the movie theater. I've brought food in, but I've also paid the, you know.
Yeah.
You have your good days. When you get older, you be a little mature. You go and buy the stuff in the movie theater.
I've definitely done that. Like I do that now. Like go buy me a soda and everything, and pay the price. It's like whatever.
But I learned that from my grandmother. We used to take us to the movies and buy. We used to buy, bring our own chips and like. So that means the movie theater stuff was always dead wrong. It was always too much. Much money. It's always overpriced.
It was always expensive for no reason.
$6 for a soda? Where?
Fuck that. Let's go to the store. Pay $1.25 here. Put that in your jacket.
But so what you working on right now, art-wise?
Art-wise, I think right now I'm setting up the next drop of merchandise I want to do. Like how we were talking about artists or musicians and how they gotta make money. For me, the merchandise has been helpful. So I'm waiting for some samples to come back so I can do a next drop. I'm pretty much almost done. I'm done down to like the last three pieces of the collection I wanted to do.
Okay.
So the next thing is like plotting on like venues and stuff. But then it's kind of like, what does the world look like next year? I don't know. So it's kind
of. I was going to ask you if you had any set ideas of doing any type of shows.
I want to wait till April.
Oh, wait, that's like, enough time to see. Things are either going to be better or like something got to give by then.
That's why I'm thinking like April, like mid-April for that.
And then if not, you're going to have to really start contemplating something virtual if you really want to get the.
Yeah.
Do it right. You can still, you know.
Well, I thought about if I had to do virtual, just like find like a photo studio and just kind of like set it up and then
it's just
figuring that whole thing out. But, you know, like the in-person effect of people,
course.
You know, still a thing. And then right now doing a lot of commissions. I did like a holiday commission sale. I got a few people that hopped on that. So starting to work on holiday paintings for people.
All right.
Yeah, I got like four of them I gotta do.
With me right now, I'm working with this group of kids, like 17 group of kids on this project. And we're gonna do a final show in December. So I'm hoping things don't get shut down so we can just finish what we're doing because it's going good. So I'm working with two groups, a music and an art group. So the music, we've been, we have all these topics that they come up with and they're creating art pieces with it. And the music kids made songs. We actually recorded some last week.
That's lit.
We're gonna do like a performance at the end, you know, trying to get a little vibe. Obviously, it won't be, you know, too packed, but
yeah,
we're gonna do it, you know, for the parents and stuff like that.
That's dope.
So I'm hoping we don't like things don't get shut down before this early December. But we'll see. We might have to, we'll do something virtually. Like, we have no choice, but
yeah,
like you said, the physical, the in-person stuff is always best for those type of exhibitions, you know?
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
Yeah, so, you know, but we here, we're going to be definitely being more consistent, doing the podcast, documenting things, bring people in, get some interviews. Maybe we could do some, like, panel discussions, too, here on Zoom, have a few people come in.
That'd be lit.
Discuss some topics. Bring Kyrie. You know, he like to talk.
Oh, he will have a field day with this. I can already see it.
Yeah. So, yeah, but other than that, that was good catching up with some stuff. We're going to sign out and see y'all next time. And no glitch. Your internet, the Wi-Fi is strong.
It held strong this time.
Yeah.
It held through.
All right, y'all.